Poorly maintained firewood can turn the dream of a warm fireplace into a homeowner's nightmare. Wood-infesting insects like termites, carpenter ants, and powder post beetles can take over piles of seemingly untouched firewood. These pests can potentially spread to other structures and cause thousands of dollars in damage. So in this video, we'll explain how you can prevent pests from infesting your firewood and save you the cost for repairs. For the products in this video and to learn even more about keeping pests out of firewood, click the icon on the top right of the screen or click the links in the description below. The best thing you can do for your firewood and the rest of your home is to take measures that will keep it from pests in the first place. Insects like termites or wood-boring beetles can see a pile of firewood as an all-you-can-eat buffet, while other pests like rats or mice will see it as a potential nesting site. Protecting your firewood starts by selecting the proper spot to store it in. Firewood can be a host to many insects and even rodents. If an infestation were to occur, it's best to keep the firewood as far away from your home as possible. If firewood is kept close to the house, then infestations have the potential to spread indoors. We recommend you pick a spot that's 20 to 30 feet away from the edge of your home's foundation. If your property doesn't extend that far, then just pick the furthest point from your house. If possible, avoid keeping your firewood against a fence or wall. Keeping your firewood stacked against a wall would hinder air circulation, and the vertical surface can provide insects with access. Remember, the further your firewood is kept, it's less likely to help an infestation spread. The next step is to elevate the location where your firewood is stored. You want to keep the wood off the ground where pests have easy access. Many households purchase firewood racks for easy and stylish storage, but you can also use materials as simple as pallets to stack your firewood on top of. Even assembling a platform of cinder blocks or bricks can help immensely as you're trying to keep insects and rodents away from your wood. Next, you'll need to get a tarp big enough to cover your firewood. If you're storing freshly cut firewood, just use enough material to drape over the top and several inches down the side. The tarp's main purpose is to prevent your firewood from getting wet from rain. By covering just the top, you'll protect your firewood from a bulk of the rainfall and encourage air circulation and evaporation over time. If you're storing seasoned firewood that's ready to be burned, then you can use a tarp to cover all sides. When it comes to using firewood, use the oldest pieces first. Older wood is likelier to rot and creates a more conducive environment for pests to infest. We suggest you rotate older cords of firewood towards the top of the stack for easier reach. This also keeps older firewood out of the reach of insects, so it's a win-win scenario. Finally, if you're one of many homeowners who purchase firewood instead of chopping it yourself, buy your firewood locally and consistently from the same source. It's always good to support your local economy, but also if you buy non-locally, you run the risk of introducing non-native invasive insects and transporting them. On the off chance you buy firewood that happens to have insects, you at least know there's a chance for the same insects in future purchases, leaving you better prepared and with time to treat accordingly. If you've ever wondered, can I use pesticides to treat pests inside my firewood? The general answer is no. Do not spray your firewood with pesticides unless you're using a product that's specifically labeled to be applied to firewood that's ready to burn. If you burn firewood that's been treated with pesticides, you may release harmful toxins into the air that can pose a threat to you and your family if burned in your fireplace. However, you can use residual insecticides to treat the area around where you store your firewood. It's always easier to prevent an infestation than to treat one. To stop most wood-infesting pests from infesting your firewood, use a product like Silo Insecticide. Silo Insecticide is an emulsifiable concentrate that's labeled to treat and repel many pests, including wood-infesting insects like termites, carpenter ants, carpenter bees, and wood-infesting beetles, including powder post beetles. Silo can be used in several ways to stop different pests. Depending on how you use it, you'll mix an amount of silo with water according to the label's mix rate. We recommend you use a 1-gallon hand pump sprayer because of its versatility and ease of use. To mix silo in a 1-gallon hand pump sprayer, fill your sprayer halfway with water, then add your measured amount of product. Fill the tank to the 1-gallon line and shake to ensure an even distribution. Pump the sprayer a few times to produce a low pressure spray. To treat nearby surfaces like walls, fences, or tables, make a surface application with silo with a 0.1% emulsion. That's made with about 1/2 ounce of silo and 1 gallon of water. Lightly coat outdoor surfaces with the product and wait for it to dry. Silo is a repellent insecticide, meaning that labeled pests will detect its presence and avoid treated areas. Any labeled insects that come in contact with the spray or the chemical residual will be killed. Alternatively, you can make a barrier application around your structure or fence line with a 0.1% emulsion. Simply spray around the structure or fence's perimeter, spraying 3 feet up the structure and 3 feet out. Pro tip, you can even treat the soil underneath your firewood and protect it from carpenter ants by treating it with a 0.25 to 0.5% emulsion. That comes out to 1.3 to 2.6 fluid ounces per gallon of water. This method will require you to apply 1 gallon of your emulsion over 10 square feet of treatment area. If your sole concern is carpenter ants, we also recommend you use a product like FICAM Insect Bait. FICAM is a ready-to-use, granular insecticide that's weather and moisture resistant, making it effective for long-lasting control. You'll spread the granules at a rate of 6 ounces per 100 square feet. The proper technique is to spread the granules in a 2 to 4 foot band around the perimeter of the firewood pile. For added control, you can also spread the product around any trees or round structures at the same rate. If you're looking for non-chemical ways to deal with infested wood, there are several things you can do. The first is to freeze your firewood. By keeping your firewood below freezing temperatures for at least 3 days, you'll kill the insects inside the wood. It's best to use a commercial freezer, a cooler with ice, or an ice chest. Don't use a kitchen freezer, as you'd risk contamination and infestation by doing so. Another method is to heat your firewood just hot enough to kill most insects. This method works best when you're planning on storing your firewood for longer periods of time. On a warm, brightly sunny day, wrap infested wood with a cloth, then seal it in a layer of plastic wrap. Leave the wrapped wood outside and wait several hours. The greenhouse effect created by the plastic wrap will cause the temperature of the wood to steadily increase throughout the day. When the wood has been kept over 140 degrees Fahrenheit for a few hours, then any insects that may be inside the wood would have died. Alternatively, you can also use an oven to bake the wood. This may take as long as 7 hours, as the firewood's internal temperature must be over 140 degrees Fahrenheit to kill insects. If you're dealing with rodents in the area, we recommend you lay easy set snap traps along the perimeters of any structures. Easy set snap traps offer secure placement with a quick and efficient kill. To set an easy set snap trap, bait the trap's trigger plate and simply pull back on the upright bar until the trap locks into place. When set properly, any rodent that triggers the trap will be killed instantly. You'll need several traps depending on the size of your outdoor space, but we generally recommend you set each trap 10 feet apart and out of the reach of children and pets. Finally, just because firewood is infested doesn't mean it can't be used. You can still burn it outdoors in an open fire pit or have it mulched. Either process will kill any insects or eggs that may be inside. You don't have to throw the infested wood out, but it's recommended you do something with it as soon as possible to prevent infestations from spreading to other pieces or your home. Firewood is a necessity for many homeowners that can easily become infested with bugs or rodents, but there are ways to mitigate risk and prevent an infestation from getting out of hand. With these professional products and tips from Solutions Pest and Lawn, you can keep pests from infesting your firewood. We offer same-day shipping to help you get control quickly. Visit our website to get your products today. If you like this how-to guide, please share. And if you're new to our channel, subscribe for more how-to and product videos, and contact us for more tips, tricks, and DIY pest solutions.